Hello, everyone. My name is Edward Rojas. This past summer, I, along with my colleagues Eric Exner and Kunden Pago, under the guidance of Dr. Omar Al-Radaya, created a T-RIS-based tool for remanufacturing using additive manufacturing. First, you should understand what additive manufacturing is, and this is a term that applies to the technology of depositing successive thin layers of material, which can range from plastic, metal, or wood, onto each other, which produces a final 3D product. Additive manufacturing is currently a $9 billion industry, which is seeing rapid growth day by day and is being researched for its extensive amount of uses, one of them which we are exploring in this project, which is remanufacturing of expensive parts. The possible applications of it include in the medical field, creating 3D printed prosthetics, in the automotive industry, creating fuel pistons, and in the aerospace industry, creating entire turbines for planes. Another term that's important to understand is remanufacturing, and this is essentially the process of returning a used product which has undergone its entire life cycle to the original equipment's performance from the customer's perspective. And with this newly remanufactured product, you give it an equal warranty to that of a newly manufactured equivalent. So essentially, it's just returning the condition of a fully used product back to that of a new one. This is a process that is economical, saving 20 to 80% of cost compared to creating a whole new product. And it's also good for the environment, using 50 to 80% less energy. There are a lot of challenges, however, in remanufacturing, as good as it may be, because of how hard it can be. The remanufacturing cycle is shown on the right. And a lot of these steps, such as disassembly, cleaning, and inspection, they may not be possible for certain devices because they're not able to be taken apart. Parts may not be able to be easily, taken apart from each other. So it is not readily available in literature. There hasn't been too much applications of this. And that brings us to the usage of T-RIS. TRIS is a Russian problem-solving tool developed by Genrich Achtruller, and it means the theory of inventive problem-solving. And TRIS solves problems by observing commonalities of solutions discovered in the past and then applying them to problems that are present right now. So this is simplified through the flowchart, and essentially all you do is you run into problems throughout your project, and you have specific problems as a result. With these specific problems, you go to the TRIS matrix and you identify general problems that are similar to your specific problem. And through this matrix, it will give you general solutions to the general problem. Using these general solutions, you determine which would apply best to your problem and determine specific solutions. Some may be worse than others, but you identify those through solution selection to make the best solution. And now I'll be handing it over to Eric to wrap everything up as well as give a demonstration on the tool.
Hi there, this is Eric, and I'm going to be talking about some of the objectives that we had coming into this project and the outcomes that we've obtained. So coming into it, we set out a clear goal to develop a tool based on the principle of TRIS that's meant to solve contradictions in additive manufacturing. Now, all of this was supposed to be based off of the master's thesis by Ken DeCurie in 2019. As a result, we have developed a tool to successfully resolve contradictions in additive manufacturing with remanufacturing. With this tool, it's a pretty simple user interface that really makes it possible for novices to use. And in the future, we hope that this tool will help create new developments in the field of remanufacturing. And now I will be walking through a brief example of using the tool. Now, here we can start off in the introduction to the tool page. And this is just a very brief explanation of how the tool works. And some of the functions of it if you are not watching this video. Now, the tool, what it does is you go into it And the first thing that you're going to do is select an improving parameter. So now these are the 12 improving parameters that we have. And they're going to be the exact same as the worsening parameters over here on the top. Now, of course, there's not going to be a solution if you have the same improving and the same worsening parameter, because that would not make sense. So now I will show you the user interface. So you go over to the sheet REM AM Triz, and you start by clicking Begin. Now, this slide is where you're going to be selecting your improving parameter, so that's going to be your y-axis. So we'll go with time required for this one. You click Next, and now we are going to be choosing the worsening parameter. So for this one, let's go with the length of product. Then you click OK. Now, as you can see, there are a few principles that show up. They're all assigned a number, and the name, we include a brief definition, a short example, and a visual aid or a link to a helpful resource about it. Then, of course, we have our sources over here. And to remind you what the improving and worsening parameters are, we have them listed up here. Now, to make sure that this is correct, we have chosen time required and length of product. You can go over to the contradiction matrix and see time required, length of product, and you notice that the parameter numbers are the exact same as all the principles over here. If you just want a list of all of the principles, then you go over here to the examples page, and there will be an entire list of the principles here. And that is a brief overview of how this tool works. Thank you for your time.